Hey everyone, Chris from RhinoTech here. Got a little video we're gonna do today. We're gonna be working with our RhinoDARK and SingleStep paper. SingleStep is gonna be for light garments and RhinoDARK is for dark garments. So today we have this black shirt and I wanted to put an image on the front and back side of this shirt. So you may be asking, well, you said SingleStep. That's a light garment paper, but you have a dark garment shirt. Well, why would you be using SingleStep on a dark garment shirt? Well, if you stay tuned, I'll show you what you can do with single step and light garments. Hold on one second.
Here you come, here you come.
All right, magic is foil. Even though single step is for light garments, doesn't mean that you can't put it onto a dark garment. You know, the single step will adhere to cotton or polyester or blend. So obviously the shirt color really doesn't matter. You know, the material's still cotton or polyester. So we're going to end up putting a foil on top of it so that you're going to be able to see that image. So we're going to do a test of transferring to single step, showing you what it looks like without the foil, and then putting the foil on top of it to show you, you know, what you can do with a light garment paper on dark garments. So let's get the process started. We're going to print some sheets off and then press them up. Be right back. Let's print. This is going to be really exciting. Ooh, scary bat. Scary face.
All right, we're back. Got everything printed. Got our little bat guy. Got a little scary face guy. Well, let's get doing some transfers. All right, we're gonna take a single step and we're gonna do it on this black shirt.
Single step, weedless transfer paper, no need to trim this. And do 330 degrees for 25 seconds. And we're gonna give it about a 7 to 10 second peel. Could be a little bit longer depending on your press. And as you see, no toner left on the paper. So now let's flip this over and we're gonna do the RhinoDARK. But first, in order to do the RhinoDARK, it's a two-part system. So we're gonna do the A and B sheet. All right, now we're back. Now we're gonna work with the RhinoDARK. We have our little face guy here printed on the A sheet or image sheet of the RhinoDARK. And then the RhinoDARK is a two-paper system. So you're gonna have a B sheet that you're going to heat press to the A sheet. The sheet is going to more or less act as, you know, it helps with the adhesion to the garment and it also blocks your garment color from coming through your print color. Well, let's get these two married up. I always like preheating the bed of the heat press to start with because it helps with the transferability of the two sheets if you have the bottom, you know, just as warm or at least warmer than room temperature compared to the top. So just a few seconds, doesn't take very long. I like to use a little parchment paper just to make sure if I put something upside down that I'm not ruining my heat press bed. And same with the top. I always have the image sheet on the bottom
and a transfer sheet on the top. And with the RhinoDARK, we're going to do 315 degrees with this heat press. Instructions are anywhere from 310 to 330 for a minute and a half. There's going to be a hot peel on this. Always roll it back upon itself. Never straight up in the air, otherwise you can lose part of your image on that image sheet. And there we go. And we now have the B sheet coating where the toner was has released to, I can grab this here, to the image sheet. And then the areas where the toner was not is still on this B sheet. All right, so when you do that, you will have to trim this paper ever so slightly on the edges because some of the B sheet does transfer to just the edge of the paper. So you just do a quick trim around and then we're gonna throw it on the shirt. All right, we're back. We're ready to transfer these images to the garment. We do have our RhinoDARK with the little face guy. We got the edges trimmed up to make sure B sheet coating doesn't transfer over to the garment. We do have our original garment from earlier in the video with our little bat guy in there. I'm not sure if you can see him, but you'll see it a lot better once we apply that foil on there. But we're going to go ahead and put the face guy in front of the shirt here. So what we're going to do the front and back is we're just going to lay down parchment paper or silicone paper onto the bed of the heat press. Lay the garment down and then go ahead and press. It's not going to hurt any of the images to be repressed. Let's get our parchment. Get our shirt lined up. Face guy. Get them lined up as best as possible, and this RhinoDARK, we're going to do the same temperature for about 30 seconds. And the same temperature was 315 degrees that we did A and B sheet. Alright, so the RhinoDARK, this is going to be a cool peel, so you're going to want to set it off to the side for about 30 seconds to a minute at least, just to make sure it's not warm to the touch. And so as we're doing that, I'll peel my silicone or parchment paper off the back, and you know, nothing wrong with my little back guy. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go trim some foil up and get this ready to be foiled. Alright, so we're back. I figure I'd show you what it looks like when you're peeling the A sheet off of the RhinoDARK off the garment. What I like to do is I like to grab it, and if possible, I just roll it. And just roll it right off the garment. That way you have no issues. If you're taking it and you're pulling up, good chance that's going to come back off the garment. But as you can see, absolutely nothing left on there. So now we have scary face, bat. We'll be back. All right, we're back. We've got our face on the shirt, bat on the back. So let's make this bat stand out with a little bit of foil. All right, so when you have image on both sides, you're gonna do repress another side, like I said before. Make sure you have parchment paper, silicone paper down. So put that down, that shirt over the top, and foil, hold on a sec. I'm back. Sorry it took so long. Got my piece of foil right here. Make sure you cut a piece big enough. You can take this foil and leave it plain, or you can wrinkle it up to make it look a little distressed. However you want to do it. Put the colored side up. And then once again, I always like covering things with parchment. And we're going to press this foil at 330 for 30 seconds. Go. Alright, so now with the foil, this is going to be, you're going to peel this cool. So you're going to wait another 30 seconds to a minute to peel this off. Instead of, you know, waiting that time, you can throw it aside and start your next project, come back to it. Even if you leave it for a couple hours, it's not going to be the end of the world. Alright, we'll be back while this cools down. Alright, we're back. We're going to take this foil off. Sometimes I like to take a little piece of cloth, just kind of rub it on the foil. Make sure everything adhered correctly. And voila! We now have a purple scary bat. Ooh! Alright, back again. So, we just got done putting the foil onto our bat. So now, even though it was done with a single step, which is for light garments, we did it on a dark garment, put some foil on top of it, and now we have nice little foiled design. And then we used our RhinoDARK to do the face on the front. So whatever paper you want, we have a solution. Whatever garment color you have, we have a solution. Keep watching our videos. Chris from RhinoTech, take care.